Good morning, everyone. I hope you're all keeping safe and well, and you're looking forward to today's conference. Excellencies, our distinguished guests, professors, students, ladies, gentlemen, and our non-binary friends, welcome to the conference, European Universities, Pioneer in Transformation, Education, Research and Innovation. This conference brings together representatives from European universities, including rectors, presidents, and coordinators, but also students, researchers, and academic staff. What makes a campus community? We have representatives from the European Commission and member states, as well as relevant stakeholders from business and society. To open this event, we are now going to listen to the Minister of Science, Technology, and Higher Education in Portugal, Mr. Manuel Heitor.
Thank you very much. Bom dia a todos and good morning to everyone throughout Europe that are participating in this event. A special thank to the Polytechnic of Leiria, the institution where I am, and the coordinator of one of the 41 existing European alliances of institutions of higher education, which is particularly important and relevant in the current context. Why? Certainly, over the last 20 to 30 years, we have understood throughout Europe how important is particularly mobility of students and the exchange of staff for research and innovation, but as well as the development of joint programs to help building an European culture and to build what we understand to be more and more European values, certainly in terms of building trust between youth and the development of our regions. We have also understood that one of the important elements of the European values are the diversity among different regions. And that diversity needs to be preserved, but also needs to be needs to be created as one of the values of this European culture, essentially understanding the need to diversify and specialize different regions, certainly by partnering the regions themselves, and universities and institutions of higher education are particularly critical in the building up of this relation. Actually, the alliance coordinated by the Polytechnic of Leiria with institutions in the Netherlands, in Ireland, in Austria, in Hungary, has been particularly promoted by bringing together regional authorities, local authorities, institutions of higher education, and leading economic and social actors in each of these regions, certainly to help understand the diversification and the different specialization patterns of different regions. But although these regions are different from themselves, certainly they learn from each other, and certainly it's true the making of real living labs where the new generations can understand European diversity, that we can certainly build a culture, a true European culture. So therefore, I do believe that the idea of European universities are more important than ever to build them a next step in the European project by providing environments which are different from each other, but certainly engage students in building up that understanding of the diversity throughout Europe, which we should preserve and certainly better understand. Certainly, we live in unprecedented times, very much as a result of the pandemic crisis that affected all of us in Europe and the world at large, but also times where people understand more than ever the value of knowledge, either through learning, through research, but also through innovation, in facing this pandemic and the social and economic crisis associated with the pandemic. We have now the capacity to test, we have the capacity of better therapies, and we have vaccines, and all of those have been associated with the capacity existing in research and innovation activities to do more and faster. And although we have advanced enormously also in the way teaching and learning systems have been adapted through these times, we know that the challenges ahead are enormous. We need to do more and better. We need to better understand the pedagogy of learning and teaching systems. And we need to also to understand that the pandemic crisis has created a number of new opportunities for digital systems, but at the same time, coexist a number of increasing inequalities. And again, the only way to solve these inequalities and to help improving our performance is to learning from each other, is to exchange experiences, and this center, and above all, put the students in the center of our activities. And that is the main purpose of my presence in this session, is to call your attention for the need to mobilize all our activities, particularly in the European universities, towards student-centered and European citizens-centered activities, to better understand the needs of our society, and that will certainly create a trust relationship between population at large and the regional context in particular and the institutions of higher education. And this is important for my understanding in four main challenges Europe faces. First, the enlargement of higher education. In December 2020, Europe at large has achieved an overall education attainment of 40% of those aged 30 to 34 years old with higher education degree. This is the average European participation in higher education. We know that some areas are quite above, but we still have in Europe areas below this 40% graduation level among those between 30 and 34 years old. In Portugal, we have passed actually the 40% target last year, and we have understood how difficult it was over the last 20 years to set these targets. But to set the goal that Europe at large, throughout every single European region, we may have by 2030 50% of those aged between 30 and 34 years old with higher education do require a collective effort between certainly the institutions, the employers, public and private employers, and certainly the regional authorities throughout Europe. And we know that the enlargement of higher education needs definitely to happen together with the diversification of learning and education systems and the specialization of some institutions. And these do require research and development and the strengthening of the research to facilitate diversification. And we are facing now unique challenges for the transformations we are observing in the economic activities, from the automobile sector to the aeronautical and the aerospace and aviation sector, but also in the tourism and hospitality, in the food value chains. Enormous changes has been accelerated by the opportunities of the digital transformation, but more and more by the challenges of the green transformation. Achieving carbon neutrality by 2050 can only be done with a skilled population and a shift in the way our behaviors face economic activities. And this is a unique opportunity, particularly because of the pandemic crisis we understand, because we also know that this pandemic started in animals, it passed to human beings, and it is, like scientists usually say, one of the ways climate change affects our life. And that definitely Europe, particularly through the European Universities Alliances, could play a particular role in leading this process of transforming our way of living to a more ecological way. But this needs, certainly, the specialization of some activities with more knowledge from the hydrogen economy to the electrification of mobility. We need certainly to deepen our knowledge on basic processes, for example, to guarantee the electrification of mobility, we need to better control not only green mining of lithium, but above all, the development of a new generation of solid-state lithium cells. But also in other areas, for instance, in the hospitality management, where enormous transitions have been occur in the consequence of the pandemic, and above all, in the food value chain. We know that agriculture at large in Europe has been, in the last decade, one of the most serious ecological footprints in Europe. And particularly, to change that way, we need definitely to better understand how to adapt agro-food sector to a green, to the green transition. And so, therefore, the role of European universities in diversifying and in facilitating the specialization of our economy towards a green and a digital society will be particularly important. And we know that this needs more knowledge, but certainly needs a context of institutional innovation, which again, bringing regional partners, economic and social partners, and institutions of higher education is particularly important in creating employment which is sustainable in the long term. Again, the pandemic crisis we face brought us new challenges. We have now a new, a large number of kids entering in the job market in a full digital system. And we have also a number of new students, new income students entering into higher education in a full digital setup. And therefore, we need to really understand and to be aware of the specific needs these youngsters need in order to better adapt for the creation of employment in conditions which are different from those which we typically have observed. But either for the enlargement or the diversification of the higher education or the better conditions to create jobs, we need to understand the diversity across Europe and therefore mobility of students, mobility of staff, joint education programs and more joint recruitment of teachers and researchers will be the key challenges of European universities. So I thank you very much for engaging a full day of work. I thank you certainly Commissioner Maria Gabriel for her full energy dedicated to enlargement and strengthening the support of the European Commission to the European University Alliances, and certainly to Tamis Crisifidio, the Director General for Education, Youth and Culture, that I believe will also address this audience by again providing the instruments the Commission is putting together either through Horizon Europe, but most and foremost through the new Erasmus framework for 2021-27, which we all hope can strengthen and can further invest on the alliances of European universities. But certainly these alliances leave out people, leave out all of you that has been able to create to foster, to promote and work every day in building up of a better European context. So I thank you very much for your mobilization, and let me congratulate all of those that have been associated in the development of this conference, and in particular the Polytechnic of Leiria, by organizing the event and by promoting the engagement of students throughout Europe into this process. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much to Minister Manuel Hector for your opening speech. Also in this opening session, we would like to hear from the Director General for Education, Youth, Sport and Culture of the European Commission, Mrs. Temis Christoph-Idau.
Good morning to all of you. Thank you, Minister, for your welcome, and thank you for always providing an inspiring opening speech for the conference. Your words I couldn't agree more with, and they are going to guide us through the day, I believe. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure for me to open this conference on the transformational potential of European universities. I am pleased to see that today's event is the result of the cooperation between the Portuguese Presidency and the Instituto Politecnico de Leiria, coordinator of the regional university network European University, one of the 41 European alliances, European universities alliances we have. Instituto Politecnico de Leiria is one of the 280 higher education institutions receiving support from Erasmus Plus and Horizon 2020 to turn the idea of European universities into reality. Let me share with you a few thoughts that I hope will contribute to the interesting panel discussions on the agenda today. Achieving the European education area by 2025 means that learners, academics, and researchers are able to study and work across the continent, and for institutions to collaborate with one another in Europe and beyond. If we consider our European rights of freedom of movement, of the right to work anywhere in the EU, and our daily interactions within the EU's single market, an education area does not seem unachievable. Yet, there is work to be done to ensure that seamless cooperation takes place between education institutions in all member states. Looking at higher education, the landscape is changing fast. Higher education institutions are asked to accelerate their transformation with a greater focus on the learner and provide more personal and flexible learning paths. The higher education sector is also expected to provide solutions towards a more digital and greener Europe, as well as to equip people with the competences that our fast-changing society needs. To get there, we're working with the higher education and research community and member states on a European strategy for universities. It should cover all missions of higher education institutions, education, research, and innovation at the service of society. It should provide the right incentives for enhancing synergies between the European education area, the European research area, and the European higher education area. From the consultations held so far, your feedback demonstrates the wish for a strong focus on inclusion, on innovation, on connectivity, digital and green readiness, international competitiveness, fundamental academic values and ethical principles, but also employment and employability. What is clear is that the wider higher education community and member states count on the European Universities Alliances to lead the way towards future-proofed and resilient higher education institutions. This transformative education is synonymous with European universities. Irrespective of whom I speak to, be it higher education leadership, staff, and most importantly, students, the message delivered is clear. The The added value of deeper cooperation has taken root and is bearing fruit. European universities embody the European spirit, inclusion and excellence. They're transforming education and training by working together as equal partners, covering various regions of Europe, working with national ministries of education, research and innovation to advance and integrate policies. They are working together with non-academic partners and their wider communities to address grand challenges, and while making sure your alliances are student-centric. I'm happy to say that from the feedback I receive from governments, academics, staff and students, European universities are indeed rising to the challenge. They're tearing down barriers to spearhead transformation. What does this transformation translate to in the context of achieving the European education area? I know that you're all working very hard to implement some of the key European education area initiatives. The implementation of automatic recognition of learning periods abroad. The simplification of the administration of these modalities with the European Student Card. The introduction of micro-credentials to promote lifelong learning and flexible learning paths for learners, including professionals from the European workforce. The improvement of quality assurance to accommodate new ways of working together. The mainstreaming of education for environmental sustainability and the promotion of gender balance and of STEM education, just to name a few. I applaud all for being drivers, preparing learners of today and tomorrow, for economic recovery and social cohesion, and for fostering a sense of European belonging. This gives me confidence that you will all achieve your goals to enhance mobility of students and staff through innovative mobility formats, including physical, blended, virtual, and collaborative online international learning. That you will enable students and staff to learn, to teach, to do research, and to cooperate across disciplines, borders, languages, and cultures. What do we have here today? The Running You European University, coordinated by the Instituto Politecnico dell'Iria, and with partners from all over Europe, from Finland to Hungary, from Ireland to Austria and the Netherlands. As the audience assembled today may know, the European universities represent different models of cooperation. RunEU will, amongst other objectives, be a driving force for higher education transformation, taking better account of regional needs and addressing regional disparities in education, in research and innovation. The memorandum of understanding that will be signed between RunEU members and regional government representatives is a true testament of the active role that this alliance will play in the social transformation of the regions. Supported by a long-term vision with a multitude of committed associated partners from the northern region of Portugal and other countries from the alliance, RunEU will construct the European Zone for Interregional Development. RunEU will create interregional European innovation hubs with industry and regional stakeholders focused on three strategic areas: future industry and sustainable regional development, the bioeconomy, and social innovation. They will reinvent innovation capacity, business models, market orientations, and expansion of entrepreneurial mindsets, and bring new solutions to their surrounding innovation ecosystems. Ladies and gentlemen, European universities are here to stay. I know this is what higher education institutions, national authorities, students, and other stakeholders want. European universities need time, energy, and endless enthusiasm and creativity from their staff and their students to take shape. But all this is given. We see it every day. It's tangible. We also know that European universities will need more long-term budget. This is why I'm very happy to tell you that they will be further rolled out and further supported by the biggest ever new Erasmus Plus budget, in cooperation with other European funding instruments such as Horizon Europe. We will also work on recommendations for an enabling environment at all levels to make the European universities a reality by 2025, by tackling remaining hurdles, deeper and more ambitious transnational cooperation. It is clear that despite trends of the Bologna process, more needs to be done. For this, we will launch an open public consultation in the coming months, because we need your views and your ideas to better support you in turning your dreams into reality, to create the right conditions for the higher education sector to become more interconnected, innovative, open, inclusive, digital and sustainable. For this reason, I'm delighted that today you will discuss the transformational potential of European universities. I want to thank the Portuguese Presidency and the Instituto Politecnico de Leiria for this opportunity. And I'm convinced that together we can achieve the ambitious vision of the European Universities Initiative and support higher education institutions across Europe. Thank you for your attention.